we can.
Davis, welcome to Taskmaster. What is potential? When I was a little boy, a school teacher told my parents I had none. By the end of that year, he had witnessed me wrestle a wild stallion to the ground and skitter up the side of the BT Tower like a giant mother-loving lizard. We all have potential. We can all unlock. With the exception, it seems, of most of the following people. Please give a warm welcome to Dara O'Brien, Fern Brady, John Kern, Munya Chihuahua, and Sarah Millican. And now for a man who was once chased and bitten by a peacock in an instant he refers to as the day I lost my children's respect. It's...
Hello, everyone. Hello, Greg.
Hi.
I've got news.
Uh-oh.
Of my new project.
Oh, yeah?
A line of clothing. It's called Simply Alex. Would you like me to describe it?
Yep.
Well, it's for unique occasions. You know when sometimes your fingers are cold? Your fingers are cold, but your hands are warm.
Yep.
So I've got these. These are called gloveless fingers. Gloveless fingers for the thumb there, of course. I've also got... It's a pantless crotch. You know in this area... That's the end.
OK. It's a good job I can't roundhouse anymore.
prize task, then. What category did I suggest this time, my furry chum?
Oh, just another bloody brilliant one from Mr. Brilliant, your bloody brilliant bloody bloke, because you asked them to bring in the greatest addition to a garden.
OK.
Mm-hmm.
John, hello.
Hello, you all right?
Yeah.
I brought in a maze.
Here's his maze.
Yep.
Ooh, big maze.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you brought in a maze?
Well, I didn't bring in a maze, no. Yeah. I brought in the Leylandi plant, did
yes.
you? This is what all mazes are made out of.
So you haven't brought in a maze, you've brought in one plant.
I would have brought in a maze if I could. But you love a maze?
I do love a maze, yeah.
He loves a maze.
Yeah, and I'd be as impressed if you'd brought in a stone and said, this is a potential pyramid. I mean, it's weak. Guy's a fool. Sarah.
What I've brought in is something that I've used every single time I've sat in the garden when it's been sunny.
Right.
And it is the complete works of Shakespeare.
Oh, hang on, John, you're back in the game.
Here it is.
Perfect. Perfect for the garden.
Well, I use a heavy book every single time I'm in the garden to keep my Magnum wrapper from flying away.
All right. Like this. Lovely. Lovely.
He'd be pleased, don't you think Shakespeare would be pleased?
That's I think he'd be mortified. His whole life's work's holding down your Magnum wrapper. But fortunately for you, he's not scoring this. Tara.
I brought a thermometer, but it's a thermometer that also proves that I was an advertising model in 1920s France. And also, since on trips to France, I've discovered that it's actually a really iconic ad in France.
So there's a whole second career for you.
I was quite the character in 1920s France, yeah, with my pastis olive.
Wow. Yeah. Which is olive oil, I presume. He's...
I don't know. I just did the gig.
Incredible. Hello, Fern.
So mine is a pizza oven. It's a fancy one.
I've got a pizza oven as well, and I started the fire inside it.
I found this one really hard because I don't enjoy being in my garden at all. I live in a horrible bit of southeast London, so a lot of being in the garden is just listening to drug dealers shout at each other or trying to ignore a woman dry heaving in my garden.
Just to remind you, you're watching the light entertainment show Taskmaster.
Sorry!
Munya, can you beat any of these?
I can, G-Wagon. So...
I don't mind G-Wagon.
OK.
Make a note.
I brought in the bird that changed my life. I'm from Zimbabwe. And when we moved to England, we moved to Norwich, so virtually indistinguishable. Now, there was a lack of wildlife in Norwich, so I started to get very homesick until I met Smooth Rupert. Okay?
Oh,
now, Smooth Rupert is a black bird who would fly into my garden. All the birds were loving it. He was the bird equivalent of Snoop Dogg. Okay? Obviously, I couldn't bring him in, but I did bring in a reincarnation of Smooth Rupert as I remember him. He's a smooth guy.
Okay. What are you on about? You looked out of your window and you saw a blackbird. You mean I'm going to call that Smooth Rupert?
What, so you've never looked out the window and seen a pigeon and gone, that's an aggressive Dylan?
He won me back a little bit.
Yeah.
Let me give some points out.
So what is the least great addition to a garden?
Well, yeah, you know, you would have said it was a solitary tree, wouldn't you? Until you saw a pizza oven that someone had tipped lighter fluid over. 1 point.
Right. 1 point to Fern.
2 points to Smooth Rupert. 3 points to a ragged individual tree.
Right.
I think Dara's reward is infamy around France, and I think that Sarah's doing her little bit for making the bard relevant to a modern audience.
So?
And against all odds, I'm going to give it 5 points.
There we go, five points to Sarah Millican.
Task time.
Yes, it is. So let's get the bubbles flowing.
Hey, Alex.
Hello, Munya. Please enter the magical sphere.
Thanks.
Cool.
Hello, Fern. Please enter the wonderful ball.
OK.
Please enter the enchanted orb. You have to go into the plastic igloo, the futuristic globule.
I didn't know you could get pens that clipped together like that. I'm 46 and I've never wanted something more in my life. Cool. Turn on the bubble machine.
You may not step off or move the doormat.
Fastest wins.
Your time starts now.
But that's the bubble machine.
Yes.
Power. Where's the charge for the bubble machine?
Turn it on how? Like mechanically or sexually?
Looks like we cut in the nick of time for Munya made sweet, sweet love to a bubble machine.
Again.
Let's just crack on.
Yeah? First, we're going to see Fern and Dara in the dome.
OK.
So you've given me these special pens that hook together. Rubbish.
I'm missing the thing that turns on the bubble machine.
About 12 volts, I imagine.
Yeah. Where have you put it?
Underneath something.
Ooh, ooh. Right.
I'm dead clever, eh?
Stop.
What's happening to you? Two batteries.
How do the batteries operate? They don't operate this, do they?
Oh, be careful. Oh.
These can't be for no reason.
Okay.
This is a correct source of power, but I need to be able to open it.
Yes! There's only two bodies!
Oh, no.
Oh, that's cruel. That's not going to be enough.
I'm a little bit tired now.
Tired?
Yeah.
I keep looking at you, Cactus, as if you're the key to this. That doesn't sound right.
What if we bought other batteries under the car?
I
Zara?
So where do you think... fuck's sake.
Oh, sneaky. Oh, that's irritating.
I'll stop the clock. Thank you, Fern. It's pretty fun.
See there, so.
Congratulations, Dara.
Thank you.
Do you know the last thing that my wife said to me before I came to Taskmaster today? Always check under the table.
So you didn't heed your wife's advice?
I did not, no.
You look like you're having a great time to meet her.
I was, those are fun, yeah.
Dara was quite scientific about it. You wondered if it was a battery-powered cactus and that's where we'd hidden the batteries, whereas Fern was more an instinct, really. At one point, she said, I need to get in the car.
but I still solved it in the same way as Dara, so...
You did. But did you solve it in the same speed as the scientific chuntering Dara?
Well, so they both did about 5 minutes. I just thought I'd be more vague this time. About 5 minutes.
That'll certainly keep everyone on the edge of their seats, won't it?
About 5 minutes. Well, Dara was 6 minutes 35, Fern 7 minutes 40, so about 5 minutes.
Now, a break from the norm. When you tuck your kids into bed, instead of reading them a bedtime story tonight, tell them the truth. They're parasites and they've wrecked your dreams. We'll see you in a bit. Good people out there, and hello to all the naughty ones. Over to little Alex Horn for a little Alex recap.
So, before the break, we saw Dara and Fern attempt to activate the bubble machine in the fastest time. Sarah Millican hadn't been yet, but neither have John and Munya. Here's how they got on.
Turn on the bubble machine.
Yes, please. Is it on?
Yeah.
Doesn't look like it's on.
What the hell am I gonna do? Oh, how do you make it go all stiff?
Practice.
Oh, look at him, hello!
Why doesn't it work? Does it need batteries? Does it need to be plugged in?
Isn't it meant to go all rigid?
Yeah.
So fix the bubble machine. What, do I need a screwdriver? I bet it's in there.
Hey!
Yes. Oh, be careful.
Oh! I've never used a bubble machine. I had a Mr. Frosty.
Right then. Can't step off the doormat. Doesn't make any sense.
Why is there a dressing gown? It's got something in the pocket.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Ingenuity.
Do these clip onto each other? That's not gonna work, is it?
Yes.
No fool! No fool!
Missing a battery.
One in here, isn't there?
That doesn't come off without a screwdriver.
I need to make a screwdriver to get one out of the car.
You're gonna make a screwdriver out of the coat hanger.
That's not gonna work.
Why have you given me this? This bit. Oh, that, it doesn't feel right.
What am I missing? What am I missing? There's something on the floor. Oh my God, I found it!
Oh, you dicks! Oh, I hate you all.
Yes!
I've stopped the clock.
Knew I could do it.
All right, no. Oh, hang on. Well, that doesn't matter if it's in there. Doesn't matter.
Fucking machine turned on.
Yeah.
Thanks, John.
Hey, boys.
Wow, it was a dramatic conclusion. Manya, you know how screws work, right?
Yeah, I mean, you insert and twist like the best things in life.
Yeah, if you can get them rigid enough, of course.
Well, that's the first time in this series we'd have anything in common, so...
John, you seem to struggle to see the batteries a lot of the time.
Yeah, we had hidden secret messages everywhere. On the batteries, it all said, look down. In the middle of the string, it said, look down.
Yeah.
We weren't expecting people not to see the batteries that were right there. And also, John insisted for 5 minutes that the machine was on before doing anything. 5 minutes.
It technically was on.
Right. It didn't look on.
Well, no, I agree with
you. No, in the spirit of the task, the machine was definitely off.
Yeah. It was off. But it was on.
Give me some statistics.
Well, I think it's going to surprise you. They took about 5 minutes. And by that, I mean, John took 10 minutes 45. Manya, 11 minutes 41.
Wait, did John beat me? Can't be.
You've got to remember, Manya made a lasso with a torch. He tried to make a screwdriver out of a coat hanger. He constructed a bazooka out of the pens and the cactus and the battery.
You did spend a lot of time recreating an episode of The A-Team. I think Sarah was fast. Was she fast?
Well, I can tell you that in last place, it's Manya with over 11 minutes. It's 1 point. John gets 2 points with his 10 minutes 45. Then it's Fern with 7 minutes 40. Now, we know Dara took 6 minutes 35. Sarah took 6 minutes 16. So she gets the 5 points.
May I have a scoreboard update, please, Alex?
Of course you can. She's got maximum points and she's in the lead with 10 points. It's Sarah Milliken again. There we go.
Another task. Make it a good one.
Well, I'm afraid this one is actually tarpauling. It's...
Go on, crack on.
Alex!
Hi, Manya.
Fancy seeing you here.
Always here. Hello, Dara.
Oh, Alex.
Get this... Oh, come on now!
Get this tarpaulin completely in one of the containers.
You have a maximum of 5 minutes and you must select your container before touching the tarpaulin.
Also, you must tidy it. What? Tidy everything up within those 5 minutes.
Smallest container successfully filled with the tarpaulin wins.
Your time starts after you have selected your container.
And you must select your container within the next 30 seconds.
Smallest wins, smallest wins, smallest wins.
That's full of shit.
Let me pack this.
OK.
There's got to be stuff. So there's going to be stuff in it.
15 seconds before you select your container.
Yeah.
That's got balloons in. Bloody ducks again.
I'm going to pick this.
OK.
I'm going to pick...
4 seconds.
OK, this one.
OK.
This one.
OK. Which container?
The green bin.
Lots of very interesting thoughts. My eye is immediately drawn to Manya because anyone who thinks that tarpaulin is going in a bread bin is insane.
Well, wait till you see the task.
Perhaps. Who's up first?
And we're going to start off with Sarah and Dara. Your 5 minutes starts now.
Right. I mean, I folded sheets. We've all folded sheets. Why is there a snake underneath the...
Oh, no.
What?
Oh, there's a snake.
Do you want me to?
Yeah, if you could, please.
How long have I got?
You've still got 1 minute 45.
Didn't say it had to shut.
But it just said it's going to be completely in there. You've still got a minute.
That is exactly the right size. Ah.
That's your time up. Good work, Sarah.
Thanks.
I'm waiting for the bit that went wrong.
Okay, I felt like you were asked to put a tarpaulin away and you folded it nicely and you put it in the container that you've chosen and you subsequently tied it up really well. You're watching Taskmaster.
I really enjoyed it. Folding and tidying, what's not to like?
Dara, do you enjoy folding something away really efficiently?
Yeah, but I wouldn't, like, televise it most of the time.
only a madman would. You don't forget. For those people who are thinking of turning off, we've still got Bread Bin Boy to come. Right, we're off again for a few minutes. Just enough time for you to work out how to turn down your partner's advances later on. Any suggestions, Alex?
Well, I usually just pretend to be very, very sad.
See you in part three. It's the start of part three.
Yes, and fiddledy-dee, fiddledy-doo, I had an X-rated dream about you. But enough about me. Tarpaulin tidying, that's the name of the current game. Pick a container and fit it in. Smallest container successfully filled wins. We're going to see the final three now. Brady Chihuahua Kearns.
Horrible man. So what am I meant to do with these coins? How much is in here?
You're basically making me do tidying.
Yeah, this starts with a lot of tidying, yeah. Do you not like tidying?
No, it's boring.
Well, that's not a problem, isn't it? Just put it back in there.
OK, right, let's think. How do they do it for bed sheets? What do they do for bed sheets?
Do you want me to get it? I can get it.
What are you doing?
Do you want me to get it?
No.
OK.
Is there things in this?
You've got 3 minutes, Fern.
But you've put something in here. There's millions of marbles and spoons and things.
Be some sort of trick.
15 seconds.
How many minutes?
Two. You're gonna clean all that up.
Do I really though?
Mm-hmm.
Right now, it's inside, isn't it?
It's not completely inside.
Well, that's just not possible.
How do people get bodies in these? It's going to be so hard.
It's inside, isn't it?
Done.
I guess I'm going to tidy up the forks.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, that's certainly spiced things up a little bit, hasn't it? You reverted to being an angry 15-year-old Fern at the beginning.
Yeah.
Why? It's boring!
Because they made out I really had to tidy up the spoons and marbles.
Well, you did. That was part of the task.
No, I was like, someone from the crew can do that. Come on.
What I wrote down about John was, John cuts quite a lonely figure in this task, doesn't he?
We're all on our own in these tasks.
Yeah, some people just seem more alone than others. I'm thinking specifically of when you chose your receptacle, you opened it, you discovered there were balloons there, yeah. You took them all out, and then you held them for some time.
Yeah, you stood still for 80 seconds, John.
Manya, I'm intrigued as to what part of you thought that was going inside a bread bin.
I'm seeing these containers, I'm thinking, OK, obviously there's something underneath the smaller container. So I was thinking when I open the bread bin, it's just going to be like a sewer. So I'm going to open... I'm playing it out in my head. I'm going to open it, it's going to be a sewer, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles is going to be under there. What up, dude? You want to put that in there, dude? OK, come on in. Oh, but that didn't happen.
God, I never thought I would long to hear Smooth Rupert come back.
Well, look, points-wise, Sarah put the tarpaulin completely in the laundry basket and then taped the basket shut.
Yep.
Dara got the tarpaulin completely in the laundry basket and just put the lid on. He did leave one lid carelessly on the floor.
Who got the least tarpaulin in?
Munya.
Right, 1 point to Munya.
OK.
Who got the next amount of tarpaulin in?
John Kearns.
John Kearns, 2 points to him.
Mm-hmm.
Fern, 3 points. Dara can have 4, but wow. The queen, and the only one who really deserves any points, Sarah Millican!
Oh, that's right. 5 points!
Right, may we have just one more, please?
Of course. This one's well classy.
Wow! Sorry, I like to make an entrance.
John.
You all right, Al?
Alex.
Gold pen, am I being retired?
Yes, congratulations.
Thank you. It's been the best years of my life to you, Alex.
And we're very grateful.
Okay.
Baby, write down 5 wonderful words.
You have 1 minute, your time starts now.
Last year when I started learning one new word a day, people laughed at me. Now who's laughing? Me, loquaciously.
Loquacious.
20 seconds for him.
Done.
12 seconds if you want to change your mind.
Nope.
Thanks, John.
Euphoria.
10 seconds.
Sex. I panicked.
Great. Great stuff.
I doubt I'm leaving the room.
What am I going to do now?
I genuinely don't know.
I don't believe you for a second. I never believe anything you say. Apart from everything you need's on the task. That's exactly how you
all the information's talk. On the task.
How do I feel? I have made a rod for my own back. Write a classic song.
Must write lyrics for a piece of classical music.
Your lyrics must contain your 5 wonderful words.
You have 30 minutes. Your time starts now.
I'm going to give you some options.
Jesus is Lord, do you need that many wires? Is that an iPod Touch? What was it, World War II?
And is it only those words or other words?
Oh, other words as well.
Oh, okay, fine.
Oh, you wrote down the name of the song.
Yeah, it's Clair de Lune, isn't it?
Correct.
Thank you.
Oh, I think it's too poignant for this.
Too poignant, OK.
Is that Hall of the Mountain King?
Correct, for 2 points.
How many points am I getting for this? Loads. Next.
That was a banger. Yeah. Pop the next one on.
Swan Lake by Tchaikovsky. No.
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 It's too British.
Motor Mozart. Last one.
I can play this!
You don't know that one.
It's not his best.
You're not writing lyrics to that, though.
No?
Well, if he didn't...
What's it called?
Not even a good name. Sonata in C major.
I need to listen to it while I write the song, don't
I? Yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go.
But you just stand there?
Yes.
So you just kind of have to keep going back to the start. This is how I like to write my raps.
Yeah, me too. Here we go. Stop.
Pause.
OK, wheel up again.
Pause again.
Ah. And?
Where do you reckon people would sing your song?
In their heads.
Can you really play that on a piano?
Yeah, instead of having friends at school, I spent 2 years learning Mozart sonatas, and that's one of my favourite ones.
Oh, too British for me. Well, I can't wait.
OK, well, five classic songs coming up. First up, it's John Kearns.
I found a naughty Satsuma in my fantastic curry. Oh, yes, I found a naughty Satsuma in my fantastic curry. The lady on the phone said, what? Get here, you prick! I will lance you into next week. I said, I'm in my new pyjamas and I'm free. I said, I am free to complain to you.
Far off the original. The original Swan Lake Prince Siegfried fell in love with a swan and then ordered a curry.
Yeah. I am fascinated to learn more about the narrative of the piece.
So he's in his pyjamas, so he's not well, bless him.
Yeah.
So to kind of clear the cold that he has, he's ordered a hot curry. He opens the curry.
Yep.
There's a bloody Satsuma in there.
Well, John, this might seem over the top, but I think that what we've just seen is the best thing you're ever going to do.
Okay, next.
Yep, next.
Next up, let's see and hear Fern Brady.
Oh, no.
Here we are again, series 14. Who will become the house's queen? It is me, Fern Brady, me, Fern Brady. I'm the rightful queen. Dilapidated house filled with mystery. Who even bloody knows what we will see? Only one contestant will achieve the height of victory. And the toss was serendipitous. They were gifts to the taskmistress. All the other contestants, they were bootlicking Seiko fans. Dad is a big bold imbecile. Mr. Cairns is a sick witch chat. And Sarah and Monya are losers. And a stamp on their toes.
That was painful.
You saddled yourself with some stinker words, but
yeah,
it's a masterpiece, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I wasn't aware we were allowed to write a diss track.
She really took you all down.
Really did. Mm. I mean, accurately as well.
I don't know. I don't know what my word means.
You were obsequious.
Obsequious, yeah.
Oh, that you suck up to people, and you really don't. You're not. I mean, he does. He doesn't.
Wow.
Dara, you're not obsequious.
Thanks, Greg.
I think you're really cool. Break time! Can I get anyone anything from the bar? Hmm? I'll have a smooth Rupert, please. Time this time. What was happening before the break, young Alex?
Classical music, Greg, so I suppose you really should have said, welcome Bach.
No?
Next up, and putting lyrics to Debussy at last, it's Sarah Millican.
Oh, shit.
Here we go.
I'm not watching. I look out of the window.
I see greenery and some brownery. There's a toadstool, can I really eat it? I'm inside in a bralette, which is a comfier bra. Less scaffolding. With my cat who is fighting catnip. Biscuits are my catnip too. Oh look, there are crumbs in my bralette.
Yeah, she hated doing it. She absolutely hated doing that, but I think it's wonderful.
I have such a terrible history of singing, though. Like, I was in a relationship with somebody who always said, don't sing, it sounds awful. And I didn't sing for years, and that was the probably the most horrific thing I've ever done in my whole life.
Who was it who said that you sang awful at singing?
Ex-partner.
Oh, fuck you, ex-partner.
My life is now in the section of my life that is after watching that. Everything building up has been before watching that. And now my life can begin again!
I genuinely thought it was really sweet. It was certainly quite a contrast to, it's me family, it's me family.
Yeah. And the story made sense.
The story did make sense. I think it's about a woman and a cat who are both eating biscuit crumbs from a bra.
Yeah, it's a comfier bra. It's like a nighttime bra, like the sort of bra you wear on, yeah, like, a Sunday.
I know what a bra it is. Have a look.
You need a bit of structure. Sorry.
This is going to be an absolute stinker to judge. Who's next?
Now, it's Dara O'Brien.
Do you know my greatest fear of all the fears? My greatest fear is to be the victim of defenestration. That fear might seem nebulous, mysterious, fantabulous, but it spins around my head, it's quite gyratory. They used to do it in Prague a lot in olden times, political plots. But listen, now I'll tell you how it happened to me. I once met a man in Spain who said to me to do a dance. Senor, do the fandango, or the window you will go. I said, no, I will not go out the window, no, no, no. Take those foul palabras and shove them down your throat.
Before I come on to the song, my first observation is, it would have been nice to have had more of your face in the video. It looked to me like a public information song from the 70s.
Well, it's based on a real event where I met a man who said, I'll throw you out a window.
Where did you meet this man?
In Prague. He said, I will defenestrate you, which is, as you know, a very common thing in Prague in times of political upheaval. That's how they assassinate people. Of course, I don't mind telling you that. Yeah. I'm secretious.
Even during that description of what the song's about, all I'm looking at is his big head.
It did lead into my big head. It did make sense.
I don't think you have got a big head, but on that video, it's sort of, I don't know. Who's next?
Okay, there's only one person left. Manya Chihuahua.
Goodness gracious, big brows in the mansion spacious, got a posh ting and her back's bodacious, never talks slow, she's so loquacious. Real fanatic, go to the gym but I'm still an asthmatic, crowd goes wild, emphatic, money up like cash in the attic. Jovial, Alex Horn, that's a homie, yo. Is that euphoria? Is it me or did we just get hornier? I'm on Taskmaster, I'm like Greg but I rap faster. And when he raises his specs, that can only mean one thing, sex.
I think it's the most middle-class rap I've ever heard in my life. What was it about?
You know, it was off the dome, you know.
It was off the dome?
Me and the homies were chilling in the back. We were freestyling, eight-miling.
Yeah.
Real Prague smiling. We were.
Yeah, sorry, man, I don't think you heard my question. What was it about? Move some scores?
Okay.
I'm not going to give anyone 1 point. Ooh. It's probably that I'm not straight enough to appreciate rap. And also, I don't know what the hell Dara was going on about. So I'm giving Dara and Munya 2 points each. I felt the same emotion about the tangerine curry as I did about me frambedi and me frambedi. So I'm giving them 4 points each. But the one that really touched me the most, 5 points goes to Sarah Millican. Okay, it's time for me to send you to the stage for the final task of the show. Who's going to read out the task?
Dara O'Brien, please.
Throw your egg and your spoon the same distance. Both egg and spoon must cross the qualifying line. If either your egg or spoon fall off the nappet, you are disqualified. The most distanced egg and spoon each round are out. If your egg doesn't break, your distance is halved. Last player standing wins.
Mm-hmm. So one at a time, you'll go to the throwing circle with an egg and a spoon. You'll throw them both over this line. Each time, the person whose egg and spoon are furthest apart from each other will be out. It's Dara to throw first.
O'Brien approaches the play zone.
Fern, you're up next. If you could select an orange egg, please. Just so you know, we're measuring the egg, not the paint. Most of the egg has gone over the qualifying line. Ooh, it's further. It is further. John Kearns next, please. Yellow.
Gams. That is bold.
Money next, green to match him.
I hope this doesn't throw you off, but one of your eggs does contain the corpse of Smooth Rupert. Solid.
He has managed to shove the yellow egg further away from the spoon.
It's essentially a form of curling. That's fine.
Sarah Millican, blue.
It's been a while since I've had any eggs. Thank you for getting the ovary joke.
Are you going spoon first?
Is that not allowed?
It's allowed.
Great spoon game.
Yellow is out.
Sorry, John.
What, I don't get another go?
Nope.
John, just to show you out, would you put your hand on your chin, please? Yep.
OK, it's round two. Remember, if you don't break your egg, your distance is halved.
Honestly, Alex, I don't understand this one. I was asking John the rules earlier and he's, like, the worst person.
Fern might be in trouble. Oh! That has absolutely backfired on you. Oh! Oh my God.
We've lost Sarah. We've lost Sarah. Round three. Didn't go beyond the qualification line. We have lost Manya Chihuahua.
Unlucky, Manya. And to the gripping finale.
Dara!
Oh, lovely. Lovely.
is so much pressure.
It's a nice start. Here we go. Here we go.
High octane. Yes, poor old John only had one go, so he gets 1 point.
Yep.
2 to Sarah, 3 to Munya, 4 to Fern. But yet again, Dara Breen, he's just very good at this. 5 points to Dara Breen.
There he is.
And so to the final scoreboard. Well, for the first time ever, all five have the same points. No, no, nothing like that. No, we have a winner, and that winner has 22 points. It's Sarah Millican!
Sarah wins! Please go and visit your Garden of Delights! OK, we're off, and you're off too. But first, let's applaud the winner of episode 4. One more time, it's Sarah Millican!